Chris Chinook here, CES 2025. It's the Zeiss Microoptics booth here at CES, and I've learned quite a bit about holography from Zeiss, from Christoph here. They use an analog process for doing their holography. So that's very different than the way most people do their holography. They're using digital methods. With the digital method, you write one pixel at a time and change the requirements for that holographic pixel step by step in a step and repeat process across the full size of the hologram. In analog holography, you basically have to create a physical master of the optic that you're trying to turn into a holographic element. And so Zeiss has been doing optics for many, many years. And so they are experts in optical designs. And so they have created tooling now, very large meter plus optical systems for holographic exposure. And that's their big advantage that they claim for creating their holographic films. So it's not just the holography film process, analog or digital, but it's also the design process that makes a huge difference. So for example, a lot of early holographic solutions for automotive HUDs, for example, where they put the film on the windshield. If you had sunlight or street lights, the thing would rainbow like crazy, and there was no easy way to solve that problem, especially if you had optical power built into that hologram. So what they're doing now is really different. First of all, there's no optical power. So the holograms they're creating are basically optical diffusers. So that when you see the image on the windshield, it's basically at like an arm's length or 3 meters or so. It's not a true AR HUD, but it is a HUD. It is a head-up display. So it's really having the knowledge to design that diffuser within a specific eye box, whether it's a digital replication process or an analog replication process. It doesn't matter. It's really the design expertise, according to Zeiss. Automotive HUDs are already, they're not showing those here this year. They showed them last year, but they were so popular, apparently, that they have some design wins, and they're now under NDAs to develop those, so they're not showing those. What they are showing are several other concepts, some of which were shown last year as well. So let's take a look at those. So one of the applications for these films is in transportation. And they have partnered with a company called Huebner. Huebner is in the transportation field. They provide all kinds of physical components for buses and trains. And they partnered now with Zeiss to basically become a system integrator for putting these holographic films onto trains and bus windows. And you can see in this demo here, this is just using a simple Optima projector with an optimized holographic film. And you can use this for train stops or for advertising, obviously. I think this is going to be a pretty huge field. So they have a good system integrator partner to do that. They also have this transparent camera application over here. So what you can see me now in this image, I'm holding my camera. And what they have here, this is basically just a simple LCD, and they've applied a holographic film over the top of this. And what this film is doing is actually, it is acting as a grating to direct the light from out here into down, and it's acting like a waveguide. It's sending the light out here down to an image sensor, which is mounted below the display. So the grating couples the image in the, and travels down the hologram. There's then an output coupler that will put it onto the CMOS sensor, which you can then feed back right to the display here. So this is an alternative to doing a CMOS camera behind an LCD or behind an OLED panel. We've seen several of those demos here already at CES, so this is another alternative application for doing that. And another way of using that same principle They're showing over here as a holographic solar window. So the idea here is it's the same. But now instead of having all these reflective surfaces like on this hotel in the background here to mitigate the infrared light, especially here in Las Vegas, they put a holographic film on traditional window glass. Again, this now acts as a input coupler for infrared radiation, which travels down the window as a light guide, and it can be collected down below either in some kind of a panel, a solar panel, for example, or just as a heat dump. Either way, very innovative way to use holographic films. So let me try and get in their car demo here, and I'll show you that. Oh, this is their cockpit demonstrator here. I have a seat. There are three holographic films in this cockpit. Here's the first one, which is sitting directly in front of the driver here. As you can see, this is very much a diffuser. It's a slanted image. It's following the curvature of the windshield. So there's no virtual image distance at all. There's a second one over here, which I believe both are visible, optimized only for the driver. And the eye box is, you know, as I move my camera here, you can see the image come in and out of visibility. There is a third one over here, which apparently is not working. This is obviously is for the passenger. There is a back seat applications here. They showed this as well last year at CES. So this has a projector on the roof here, and then a film that would be on the windshield. It's on the side window over here. Doesn't seem to be working very well. Oh, I see. I was in the wrong sweet spot here. I was leaning too far forward. Now I'm back in the right sweet spot here, and you can see the image coming through clearly. One thing that's an issue. So this is designed for the image to be seen by the passenger inside the car. Other companies like Continental are designing side windows where the image is to be designed to be seen outside of the car. Now, one of the concerns with an image, either way, especially ones for the inside of the car, is glow. Basically, having that image visible on the outside of the car. That was the case last year. It is not the case this year. How they solved that, they said, is a trade secret. But they seem to have solved that problem indeed. Now, finally, there's some extra concepts here for taillight displays. There's this on the side of the car. All holographic film kinds of applications. And things like this on the front fender as well. Obviously provides a nice, well, it may not be able to tell on this camera, but it does provide a nice 3D effect. That seems to be mostly what I know here in the Zeiss booth. Chris Chinnock for Insight Media.